Good day, everybody. In this video, I will explain how we classify soil based on unified soil classification system. There are three soils that we're going to work with. Soil A, which is non-plastic material, soil B and C. These two soils are plastic. So to classify the soil, we're going to use the charts. We're going to start from the left and work it out through to the right, so to the end. We're going to start with soil A, and the first thing that we're going to check is how much fines it has. So we'll see how much the percentage passing through the sieve 200, which is 0.0075 size. So 0.075, that's here. So we'll see that for soil A, it will be about 2%. So I would say that fines about 2%. Which means that it's less than 50%. So we're going to use this top chart. Then we're going to look what we have more, gravel or sand. So we'll see how much percentage will pass through the sieve number 4, which is size 4.75 millimeters. And that will be 4 here. So that will be 4.75 here. 4.75. So we see for soil A, we have point here. That will be about this much, which is 66%. So this means that 66% will pass through, which is more than 50%. We're going to go here, right? So we can also calculate how much gravel we have. So out of 100% of total soil fractions, we're going to subtract 66%, which is passing through, and that will give us 34% of gravel, right? So we can also see how much sand we have. So if we have 66% passing through the boundary between gravel and sand, and then we have 2% fines, that will give us 64% of sand. Okay. So now we're going to go to the third column, and this is the same question. It's about the amount of fines, but in this case, it's subdivided into three categories. So in terms of the percentage of fines, we have 2%. So we're going to go with this box. And then here you see that we have values of CC and CU. So these are coefficients of curvature and coefficients of uniformity. We need to calculate them. To do that, we need to get percent the values of D10, D30, and D60. So D10 will be a percentage at the size of soil particles that are passing through 10%. So let's see how much we have here. It's somewhere here. That will be here, sorry. It will be 0.2 millimeters. So I'm going to write here D10 is 0.2 millimeters. So then we have D30. It's going to be here. It will go down. So D30 should be about 0.9 millimeters. 0.9 millimeters. And D60. So percentage passing 60%. So that should be about 3.75 millimeters. 3.75 millimeters. So then we're going to use formulas to estimate. We'll start with the coefficient of curvature. It's D30, value of D30 in the power of 2 divided by D10 times D60. So that will be 0.9 in the power of 2 divided by 0.2 times 3.7. That should give us a value approximately of 1.09. Okay, now let's estimate the coefficient of uniformity. So coefficient uniformity, the formula, it's D60 divided by D10 So we have 3.7 divided by 0.2. That will approximately 18.5. Okay, now let's see what we have. So we have Cu 18.5, which is more than 6. Yes, tick. And then Cc should be between 1 and 3. We have 1.09, which is also in the range, yes. So if both of them yes, in this case the answer is yes, and the soil will be classified as SW. I'm going to write it here, which is sand well graded. So that's the first soil. Let's do the same with soil B. For soil B, we know that it's plastic soil. So let's quickly estimate the plasticity index of this soil. Plasticity index is the difference between liquid limit and plastic limit. So it will be 45 minus 29. That gives us value of 16%. Okay, so we're going to do the same thing. We're going to go again through the table. So first, let's see how much fines we have. So B is here. So fines will be at this point. We'll see that the fines is about, I would say, 22%. So that's about 22%. So it's still less than 50%. So again, we're going to go here. Now we see how much percentage will pass through 4.75, which is here. So that's this point is 4.75. We'll see that almost 100% will pass through. Again, we're going to go this way, the same as in the previous soil. Now we're going to see how much fines we have, and we estimated it's about 22%. So it will fall in this box. So it's between 12 and 50%. And here you see that we're going to look at the plasticity index, and we're going to look at liquid limit. And let's just write down what we have. So we already know that plasticity index is 16, and it should be more than greater than 0.73 liquid limit, which is 45 minus 20. So we need to estimate if it's more, and it looks like it's more. So in this case, the answer is going to be, it looks like it's actually going to be less. So the answer will be no. So this actually value is greater than 16. The answer is no. And if the answer is no, the symbol that we classify the soil is going to be SM. So for soil B, I'm going to write here, it's SM. That's how we classify soil B, SM. So in this case, it will be a silty sand. Okay, now let's do soil number C, soil C. For soil C, we'll see again, we'll start with the fines, and the fines, it's here fines. So we have more than 50% fines. I would say for soil C fines would be about 56%. So in this case, you see that we have fines more than 50%. We're going to use the chart at the bottom because it's more than 50%. So now what we're going to do is look at the liquid limit of the soil and see if it's more than 50% or less. The liquid limit, it's 53.5, so the answer is yes, 53.5, more than 50%. And here again, we're going to use the formula that we used before. So this is the same formula. So that formula will tell us if it's silt or clay. So for the formula, again, we need to estimate plasticity index, which is 53.5 minus 30. That will give us value of 23.5%. So now what we're going to do is for here, maybe write it, it should be 23.5. Is it more greater than 0.73 times liquid limit, which is 53.5 minus 20. So is it correct, the statement, or not correct? So if we estimate how much is here, so that value will be greater actually than 23.5. So the answer will be no. So that's not correct. And that would leave us to soil classification as MH, which is, as you see here, elastically. And the answer we're going to here, we're going to write MH. So that's how we classify these three different soils. The soil A, it's non-plastic, we classify based on gradation. So it's going to be either poorly graded or well graded. And the other two soils, they have plasticity. So in this case, we'll classify it based on its plasticity. So we need to decide if it's going to be more silty material or clay material. Well, thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day. Bye.